Hey guys, John Rocket TV One here once again. It is a fine 45 degree day here in southern New Hampshire. Some of you guys might recognize this here roller. And a couple of years ago, I put up a video about how I bought the Ohio Steel 920 pound roller. It's like 4 feet wide, and I did that to cover over the wheels of my tractor. And part of its use around here, because my driveway is so steep, our house was built on what used to be an old sand pit, and before that it was a gravel pit, and before that it was a granite mine. And so what little bit of decent soil we have is really just a mess here with the frost heaves after the winter time. So we're about 95% of the way with snow out of my yard. And so yesterday I put down my weed and feed, step number one for the grass there, and try to get it down as early as possible. But I need this roller, or a roller, to fix my road, because I handle the whole almost 2,000 feet from my driveway to the highway. And it's steep in a lot of spots, and we got somebody else that runs up and down on the far end over there, and they can't miss a pothole, seems like. They couldn't miss a pothole, save themselves. So I got to put rubble in, and I got to be able to pack it down, and I need a roller. So this roller here is absolutely useless. And some guy on YouTube decided that he was going to say, oh, there's no way that could have happened, just having the water sit in it for a month. Well, let me say, I dare you to go down and spend your $300 like I did and put water in it, and then just leave it sit in the yard for a month and forget about it. You know, use it and then forget about it. That's exactly what happened. The thing got a flat spot, and I couldn't figure out a way to pull that flat spot out of there. The metal just, it's not thick enough to do anything. I mean, I could probably fart and explode this can. So what we are going to do is use the rest of the bracketry. We're going to carve a slot out in here right now, and with any luck, this axle goes all the way from end to end. And then I'm going to use one of those 100-pound gas tanks that I found out in the woods that didn't have any bolt holes in it. Imagine, because the other 10 of them that are out there have bolt holes all through them. Somebody tossed them out there. I don't know what. But it's like a 100-pound gas bottle, and it weighs a ton. It's got to weigh 150, 200 pounds all by itself empty. I've already got the valve off of it, and so hopefully we're going to be able to drill a hole in one end, and hopefully this axle actually exists. Otherwise, I'm going to have to cut these off of here and figure out how to make them on there. So this is the project for today. So let's cut a slice in here, because I'm going to save this metal to reskin my plow with. But the flat spot here. And so we're going to cut us an opening in here right now with the side grinder and try to figure out what is in here. Hopefully there's an axle that goes all the way through. Yeah. That's right. Yep, one orifice. Get me a little flashlight so you guys, you and me, can both see in there. I don't know. I can't see it. I wouldn't doubt it. Oh, no. We got an axle runs all the way through, ladies and gentlepeoples. Jeez, it already looks half rotted out. And it looks like they use the same axle on different ones and weld a stenchion onto it. Oh, boy. 4 foot piece of metal with the scraps. That's how they get a five. They buy fours and then make fives. Oh, see? I don't know if you guys are seeing that weldy mark there. But, yeah. Unreal. Yeah, and that metal ain't real thick. It's not even an eighth. I don't know what it is, but it's all burr you're looking at there. But that is, that's how they get it so that it's long enough. They buy 4 footers, because I can buy a 4 footer. Easy peasy, right off the rack at Lowe's or anywhere. And then it looks like they make them in fives with a little stanchion or whatever this is. Oh, boy. What else is new? Oh, 52, there you go. They add the other little bit onto it. Yeah. Okay, so we got that. Cool. Go on. Oh, Shelby. Here we go now. Here we go. Yeah. For our new little tank. Here. Yes, sir. Ohio. Ohio Steel, 920. About to be escaped from my plow blade. Yeah.
The victim. Yep. Somebody tossed a bunch of these out in the woods, probably back in the 80s, because they're just probably loaded full of whole bunch. Yeah. This thing here weighs almost as much as that all by itself. Yeah. Not at all. 50, 70 pounds at least, anyway. And the stick almost fits the hole perfect. We are going to have to do a little bit of fixing there and cut them welding off at least one side so we can get the thing through to you. Yeah, probably cut them off on both sides so that we can equalize it. Stick in the leg and cop those off of there. Yeah.
All right, and into the ledge with it, my homie quick change tool post and my, that's all made by me. Yeah, first quarter tool, perfect. Stick quarter inch tool in there, anything you want. Loosen them little set screws, stick tool bit in, done. On center, done. Anytime I have anything sticking out the back of my spindle, I always wrap it up because it's not like I got a bar feed or anything, and that thing is like 4.5 feet long. So, yeah, you don't like it to whip around and beat up the end of your spindle, so I always wrap up, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, all right. Well, anybody can see that pile of black rust stuff. There weren't nothing. I opened this. I knew I was going to do this 2 years ago, right after this happened. And so I pulled the valve out of that there, and there were nothing in that tank but a little tiny splotch of oil, which I burnt up in the stove.
You hear me? Okay. How about my shaft though? Well, stop down, take the welds off, bring the lane, we're perfect, huh? Oh my golly. Don't do the hole, will you? How's that gonna work for me? Oh, we'll have to see, eh? We're gonna have to wiggle that in there, ain't we?
Let's see how that works. I'll fix it so you guys can see, supposedly. Boldly, yeah. Well, for seeing that, but yeah, that's gonna be a little bit of a trick. I might have to stand that upside down. Might be the way to get it. Maybe I should have put it in from the other side. Who the hell knows?
I gotta go from, do I count that? It's only a half inch, that's all. Tape! vodka. On to the welder shop with it. And like I said, I got all the cream here, sand, or water. And even if my welds don't come out absolutely perfect, it's not really going to matter. 4 inches, 3 inches. It's the middle of that. It's 3.5. How about it? Come on. 3.5. How about it? Come on. Yeah, so if I do end up doing water and it leaks a tiny bit around my weld on here, it really doesn't matter because it's not that to pull over next to the hose and fill it up a little bit more. You know what I mean? Well, there's my mark right there. Always a welder shop with it.
Hey, y'all. So I'm not a welder by trade, but I've done some of my own body work, and a few years ago they bought a welder, and so for anybody that cares, there it is. It's the Clark Hot Jut Spool Gun Welder. What is it? It's a 185 SG. And that thing puts out some heat. I have actually, with the spool gun here, where is it? Right there. Actually been able to tack coffee cans together with very quick shots on low, of course. But we are going to use the high heat here. And I'm going to try to get it as even Steven all the way around as possible. So, yeah, let's try it.
We've got my ground on the other end of the rod there, and she's measured in. I got a mark off on the other side. And so we're going to put a tack on it. It don't go nowhere. We'll try to hold it up a little bit so that it's top center of the hole.
Yeah.
Well, the end of that project.
Get out of here.
How do I end up with these projects? Oh, that's right. I bought something at the store that didn't work, so we fix it. You know, I decided on concrete. Yeah, only because if I put water in it, then I got to make a plug. And if I got to make a plug and the rest of that, it may or may not leak a little bit. And if it's going to leak a little bit, I can't put any kind of antifreeze in it. So I got to make sure I drain it every year. If I fill that full of concrete, it will stay here at least until I'm dead. And then I won't care. Yeah. So yeah, hopefully I did my math right. And I got a 94-pound bag of Portland concrete and 6 5-gallon pails full of sand aggregate. And 1940 Sears Craftsman roller. Spiller. Yeah. And well, yeah, you guys watched the beginning of the video, you know that's an old gas propane tank. And I welded a little spigot on there. And hopefully this is gonna dump all right for me, because if it doesn't, then yeah. Hopefully you can see in there with the sun, and it's just about full. And I am going to break that thing off, get my chisel out, chisel that off of there because it's only tacked on there. And that worked out well, and I didn't get much on my rock, so I got to work quick and get this off of here before it dries, clean up that machine. And then I am going to probably mix up a stiff batch, more like water mix, and just to fill that last little top in, because I got just enough left in the baggie to do it with, and might as well use it up. Ain't no sense of keeping that little bit around. No good for nothing. Yeah, we might as well use it. Cool. Well, how'd that work out? Pretty good, I think. It's like right flush to my opening, and I leaned it on this little crooked angle against this tractor here, so that it will stay like that for, you know, a couple days till that solid's up, I'm going to imagine. By tomorrow it should be pretty rugged, but we're going to leave it sit there for a couple days.
Yeah.
All right. Thanks for watching.